Well, I'd like to be called an oyster farmer. I'm not sure I'm grungy enough yet, you know, but I've put in 15 years now in this industry, so just had hatchery managers okay with me, you know. I started working at Whiskey Creek at the very end of 2007. You know, it's farming, so we have good weeks, you know, bad weeks, so that's normal. But in 2007, it was just month after month after month of everything dying in the hatchery. And so that was very different.
And so Alan, he was trying to figure out how to bring his business back. He wasn't necessarily an environmentalist. He wasn't really that concerned about global warming or anything like that. He was concerned about the problem in his hatchery. And they chased out one problem after another. They thought it was metals, and they thought it was Vibrio bacteria, and they thought it was toxins from harmful algal blooms.
You know, we lost, you know, I don't know, over $100,000 worth of larvae in a couple of days.
They were right on the edge.
But we had a lot of free time on our hands with the hatchery being completely empty of larvae, and that allowed us just to step back and say, wait a minute, we need to think about something else. I had a paper on ocean acidification that had been in the hatchery for months. You know, it was like covered in seawater and fading. And so since I had time on my hands, I read that and really changed our perspective about what we needed to be focusing on. And after a number of phone calls to Burke, who I think ignored me at first because there's some crazy oyster guy calling him, but he helped us in that initial year.
You know, we know that when atmospheric carbon dioxide goes up, ocean carbon dioxide goes up with it. And we know that when ocean carbon dioxide goes up, the carbonate chemistry changes, and it changes things like the pH and then this thing called omega, which tells us how favorable the waters are for making shell.
So there's actually about a 6-hour window where an oyster larvae goes from what's called a trochophore, meaning it has no shell at all, to 80% of its body mass being shell. And so that's really the precise moment at which they really, really need to be able to take calcium out of the water and carbon out of the water and stick them together and make a lot of shell. When the pH of the ocean drops, there's less carbon. It shifts over to bicarbonate, and so that's not good.
What we found is that the exposure to the harmful conditions, to these low shell favorability conditions at the time of spawn, manifested itself in a failure of production about 2 weeks later. We expected to see chemistry at this point causes problems at this point. What we saw was chemistry at this point causes problems out here, right? And so it's this delayed effect, and it's an exposure at these critical thresholds, these bottlenecks, these challenging times in the development of the organisms. That's what's really important, and that's what we found out there.
And at that point, we started, you know, we don't wait around for the paper to come out. We just start throwing magic powder in the water and trying to make it better, you know. So we started buffering our water and raising the pH up.
When they started responding to ocean acidification at the time of spawn, their productivity came back.
It's very simple to buffer water, really. Sodium carbonate, you can just add it to seawater and it raises the pH.
And you can just go to the feed store and buy it. And so they now buffer their water 100% of the time. And they're up at something like 90% of historical production levels. And so that was pretty rewarding.
Our partnership with scientists are a big part of the reason we were able to get real-time data and understand what was happening to us. So it doesn't really matter to me whether or not people doubt ocean acidification. The science is real, and it's affecting my business. So I think we are the people who need to speak out about how important this environment is. This is my workplace, you know, this bay out in front of us, you know. I have to keep it healthy or I'm not going to be in business anymore, you know. And that's the attitude I have about it that I hope people will understand.